Hello and welcome to a brand new Doctor Who action figure review. In this video I'm going to be looking at one of the latest in the history of the Daleks line, that being set number 13 based on the Five Doctors. This set includes a First Doctor figure, as based on the portrayal by Richard Hurndall, and the Death Zone Dalek. This set is now available in B&M stores, so if you can manage to get your hands on it, do, because it's a fantastic set, which we'll take a look at now. I think the best place to start with this set is the First Doctor figure, because I think it's the figure that most people are going to be interested in this set. Not only because it's the first time in the history of the Daleks line where we've gotten a non-Dalek figure, and that is because this story only has the one Dalek, so it's can't really do a two-pack. I've seen quite a lot of people say that it shouldn't have been a history of the Daleks set, because it's not really a Dalek story, which I agree with. Should have been like creation of the Dalek set that we got last year. I think the highlight of this set for me personally is the brand new head sculpt for Richard Hurndall. The first time we've seen this officially released. Of course it was prototyped quite a few years ago, but it never saw release. This is a different sculptor then, as I believe the original sculpt was destroyed, but I think it's all the better for it because this sculpt is superb. I think character have done a really good job lately of their likenesses, and this is, you know, no exception. It's a fantastic likeness to Richard Hurndall. I wasn't sure about it from the original leaks and even the press release of the set, but I think having it in hand, it is a superb likeness to Richard Hurndall, and it's great to have the three First Doctor actors all portrayed as figures. The rest of the figure is exactly the same as your standard First Doctor, which does mean that the costume isn't particularly accurate to what he actually wore, because his costume in the Five Doctors wasn't that accurate to what William Hartnell wore. I think the only thing that really needed to be a new sculpt is the jacket, because it's a different style. It's longer than this, but they painted the rest of the costume, you know, an approximation of his costume. So we've got the plain dark grey trousers, the shiny black shoes, they painted his fingerless gloves, which is a nice touch. The cravat is just a plain black, like we saw on the David Bradley figure and the Three Doctors version from the 11 Doctors set. If we just zoom in, the waistcoat is just a plain cream with the sort of brown of the buttons, and to give the impression of the sort of twine that his monocle was on, they've just painted the band sort of a slightly darker beige than the waistcoat, so it doesn't stand out too much, but it is still there. And then of course you've got the monocle itself, which is painted silver. Even though this figure isn't 100% accurate to the costume, I think, you know, it's just nice to have pretty much a full lineup of Five Doctors figures now in terms of the Doctors, besides Trout, but there's a couple of figures you could use as substitutes, but yeah, really nice. I'm doing a quick comparison between this version and the other two versions of the First Doctor. We have the standard William Hartnell version on the left, and the David Bradley version, which came out last year, on the right. Moving on to the Death Zone Dalek. Now, this is quite a unique variant of Dalek that we've not really seen released before, and there are quite a few new sculpts on this to make it stand out just a bit more. So, if we zoom in a little, the most notable thing I think is the new dome lights, which are the much thicker sort of, quite like jars. They're much bigger and they're red, so they really stand out, which we're only ever seeing on this prop. They were probably just quick replacements when they were putting this prop together for the episode, but it's really nice attention to detail that they have done new sculpts for it. I just believe the eye stalk is new, although I have seen a few people say, I don't know whether it's true, that the Destiny of the Daleks eye sculpt that they introduced last year is a bit more accurate to the actual eye stock that was used, which would make sense because it was the last Dalek story before the Five Doctors. But I don't know. I think it looks nice. I think it's a new sculpt. But, you know, it might be less accurate. I don't know. Moving down to sort of the collar section and the neck bin, very much like we have on the Revelation of the Daleks set. We have the slightly raised neck bin to make it taller, like the 80s props. This is probably the first one to have that, but it does, if we put it next to the Destiny one while it's here, it is, as you can see, ever so slightly taller, and it does give it that more 80s Dalek prop silhouette, which is nice. I'm really glad they've done that, because it makes the 80s Daleks that we're going to get in the future of the line just a tiny bit more accurate. We just need the new skirt now, which is probably quite a big ask, but no, never say never. Now, one thing that is not the fault of character options, really, because it would be impossible to do this Dalek properly because it's pristine, and obviously the Five Doctors prop is quite well known for looking awful, because it's, I think it's probably the last time that that 60s, 70s model was used as like a main prop, and it's, you know, it's falling to bits. You can see where it's being cobbled together, mainly with the mesh. I would have quite liked to have seen them put sort of silver in the sort of mesh, just in bits, and even just a dirty wash over the full thing, just to make it look a bit battered, because it is quite a big part of that prop. But I will say, having a sort of pristine version, it is a really nice Dalek variant that I mean, it's very similar to sort of the Resurrection versions that we would get. But it's a nice variant of Dalek. The only other real issue, which a lot of people pointed out, is that there is no oval on the between the gun boxes. I don't know why stuff like this happens, because it's not like the sculpt doesn't exist. I don't know. Very often with things like this, because they did it with the Death to the Daleks set last year, with one of them, and I think that was because it was based on one of the Gorgoon props, which are the ones they blow up. So possibly for some reason that they've decided to base this Dalek off of the prop that gets blown up at the end of the scene, rather than the one that you see for most of it. I don't know. But other than the oval, I still think it's a really nice Dalek. A really nice sort of glossy dark grey finish for the main body. The glossy black on the shoulder section, on the band, and on the hemispheres on the skirt. And you've also got a nice little touch of the orange on the end of the gun there, which, you know, does make it more accurate. So there we have it. While I do have some minor gripes with this set, I still think that it is great, and I'm just really glad that we got a Richard Hurndall First Doctor, because it's one that, you know, we've kind of thought might get released quite a few times over the years, especially after that prototype leaked, probably over 10 years ago. But it's great to finally have him, especially after we got John Pertwee a couple of years ago. And I think it was inevitable after we got David Bradley last year that we would see Richard Hurndall released eventually. But I'm glad it's happened so soon. Both figures are really nice, even if there are some inaccuracies in the designs. But I think for the most part they are quite big asks, because you would have to do an entirely new sculpt for the First Doctor's jacket, and to get a proper Dalek they would have to do a fully new sculpt that's just falling to pieces. But yeah, I really like this set. If you can track it down, which I know is a big ask for a lot of these B&M sets, but I do think it's worth it if you can find it. So good luck on your hunt, and thank you for watching this review.